Some good, amen. Here are my mother and my brothers. For whoever does the will of God is my brother and my sister and mother. Hopefully today we feel that our Lord Jesus Christ is pointing to every one of us and say, here is, you are my brother, you are my sister, you are my mother, because you do the will of God. So it's like a simple equation. You do the will of God equal, you are in the family, you are relative to our Lord Jesus Christ. Very simple. Some people in other churches use this verse against the honor of Saint Mary. They say, look, Jesus said that anyone is like Saint Mary and is only depending on doing the will of God. But in reality, this is not against the honor of Saint Mary, this is not against honoring Saint Mary, but it affirms the honoring of Saint Mary. Because what Jesus said, he said that my mom did that in an amazing way. She did the will of God. She let God do his will in her in an amazing way. So she deserved to be called the Mother of God, the Mother of Christ. I remember some years ago, maybe around 10 years, more or less, a young girl heard a sermon about Saint Mary. And this young girl was really a pure girl, a very simple girl. And she liked the story of Saint Mary and the Annunciation. And she came to me in my office and crying. I asked her, why are you crying if you like the story of Saint Mary? And she said to me, I want to be like Saint Mary. I told her, okay, that's fine. God gave you the grace to be Saint Mary. But she continued, I want to have a baby in my womb without a man. This is how she thought that this is the way to do the will of God. And in my heart, I said, oh, pure girl, really. And I told her, look, you have a mission. And one day, God is going to do his mission in you. Just have in your mind that whatever God wants to do through you, you will agree. Regardless you have a babe in your womb or you do something else. And years passed, as this girl now, I know that she has a wonderful mission, is doing it. What happened with the Lord Jesus Christ when he was in earth? He said clearly that he came from heaven for one purpose, for one mission. To do, he said, I have come to, does anyone memorize? I have come to do, huh? To do the will of God. Simply, this is summarize the whole life of our Lord Jesus Christ, that he came on earth to do the will of God. And let me say it to you in another wording. I have come from heaven to let my Father do his works in me. Is that correct? Can Jesus, because Jesus, our Lord Jesus Christ said that? Yes. He could say it this way. Why? Because in another time he said, the work I do is the works of my Father in me. The Father who dwells in me is doing the work. So when God the Father wanted to show his love, to express his love to his people, he sent his Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, and through his Son, he showed his love to mankind. When God wanted to heal sick people, he worked through his Son, Jesus Christ, to heal the people. When God the Father wanted to feed the multitude, he did that through our Lord Jesus Christ. When God wanted to show his smile to his humanity, to the humanity, he expressed that smile on the face of our Lord Jesus Christ. When God wanted to show his pity, his sympathy with Mary and Martha, he showed that through our Lord Jesus Christ, and Christ wept. And this is what St. Paul said, that Christ is the exact representation of God. Christ is the icon of God. Christ is the image of God. In God, in Jesus Christ, we saw the full expression, the full representation of God the Father. And our Lord Jesus Christ said, let it be your will, not my will. He never, ever exercised his personal will, but his will became like, it is the same as the will of the Father. So here is the point, and here is the mission of each one of us today that we should discover. That you are created for a reason. You are created for a mission. And the reason, the mission you are created for is to do the will of God in you. Or in other words, to let God do his will in you. To let God do, let God does his will in you. In the prayer we say, let it be your will. Let it be your will. Saint Mary said, I am the servant of the Lord. Let it be as you said. That's to say, let it be the will of God. Let it be the will of God. And sometimes Sometimes I feel that preachers talks about doing the will of God in more dogmatic way or in more philosophical way. And we see it as a very complicated issue as to know what is the will of God and how to do the will of God. But the reality, I feel it very simple. It's a life experience that God can do His will in me every day, every moment, daily. If I have in my mind that I wanna do only His will, not my will, and I let Him do His will. And St. Paul said that it is God who is working in you to will and to do. I want you to discover yourself now that you are not existing just by yourself. You are not working or doing things just by yourself. But God is in you. God is in you with the breath of life. God is in you with Holy Spirit. God is dwelling you. And God is working in you to do His will. One thing is needed. Just don't look to your will, don't look to your pleasure, but see and look for what God wants to do for you. The will of God is a daily experience for us all. And sometimes you do it without knowing that you are doing the will of God. Allow me to give you some practical examples from the daily life, and maybe I use some symbolic names. Today we had a baptism for Emily Grace, and it is mentioned in the certificate that Father so and so, Father so and so, Father so and so baptized this person. Reality, this is not what happened. What happened is something completely different than this. What happened is God has prepared from eternity salvation to the mankind in the Lord Jesus Christ by His death and by His resurrection. And God has planned long time ago, that Emily Grace will be baptized, will be buried, will be raised with Christ. And today, God woke up early. Not Abuna woke up early. God woke up early in Abuna and Abuna. And God came, drove the car, came to the church in Abuna. And God sanctified the water in Abuna. And God carried Emily Grace by His hands in Abuna. And God immersed Emily Grace in the water in Amuna. In Abuna, and God took her out of the water in Abuna, and God anointed her with the Holy Spirit, with the oil in Abuna. Look, the story is not that we do something, it is God who is working in us. God is working in you. This story happened today. I looked to all details in my life, in the life of the church, in the life of the family this way. And I want you to share with me the same vision in seeing things around you and in your life. I gave you another example. Long days ago, long years ago, God has a vision that in St. Mark's Church, I wanted to have a very nice building in close to the church. And God put this vision in Abuna at that time and in the board at that time. And what happened that Abuna at that time and the board at that time accepted this vision. And God sent other fathers to the church that they can share the same vision or that they can accept the same vision. And God sent the wonderful congregation to the church that he will work inside them to fulfill his will. And God went and have an architect office in the person of the architect. And God drew the plans of the building with the hand and the scanner of the architect. And God has an engineering office to do all the drawings, the construction drawings, with the hands, in the hands of the engineers. And God has a position in the city, in the zoning board, in the building department. And God made all the approvals through them. Then Abuna, who has the first vision, stood before God. Yes, God, until now I can see what you have done until this moment. I am stuck, God, because I don't have the money. God said, don't say this. If you say I am stuck because lacking of money, that means I, God, stuck because lacking of money. And I have all the resources of the whole world. And if you consider this building is my building, I'm gonna work in it. I'm gonna fulfill it. I'm gonna do it. You accept this by faith. Yes, God. We shared this vision with the fathers, with the board, with the congregation. And we all said, yes, God is able to do it. And now look to the rest of the funny and amazing story. How God managed to get the money, how God is managing to get the money for the project. Before I tell you this, you know the joke of the one with the Jewish guy who found a sum of money, and they challenged each other, what is the part of the money for God and what is the part that the Jewish priest should take it. And then the Jewish priest said, we throw the money upward, and the money that God will take, it's his. And the money will fall down on the earth, it's mine. But it's a joke, yes. But I see in this joke a glimpse of lacking of understanding how God is managing our financial issues. So when we spoke with God about how he will manage to give the resources to the church, hear what happened. God found a job as a surgeon, has money, and he worked in the surgeon to earn money, and he spoke in the heart of the surgeon, give part of this money to this project. And this surgeon said, let it be your will. I agree, this amount of money is for this project. God have a job as an engineer. God has a job as an owner of a retail store. God has a job as a waiter. God has a job as a waitress. God has a job as a limo driver. God has a situation as a widow, working as a teacher. God has a job as a student, having internship, and he spoke in the heart of the student that whatever you earn this summer, you earn it for this project. It is God. And one day I told you, when I ask you to donate to the project, I'm not asking you. I'm asking God, I'm calling God who is in you to enable you to work, to give you the will, and to give you the resources or the money that you can donate to the church. Let it be your will. I came to do the will of God. Why I'm saying this? I'm not saying this as a fundraise issue for the project, by the way. And even if it is for the fundraise, no problem. But I'm saying this to have the feeling of the presence of God in you as a very tangible issue. God is not far from us. God is in us. If God wants to smile to somebody, he can smile to this body through you. By the way, if you see me smiling all the time, take it. It is not me smiling as a person to you. It is because God, who is inside me, wants to smile at you. If I hug you someday, it is not because I want to hug you, but it is God who is in me, who gave me that passion, that love, that I want to express this love through you. But if you find me angry and shouting and crying, it is not God. It is me now. So what is the difference between our Lord Jesus Christ and us as an image of God? Because what is said about Jesus Christ, that he is the image of God, the icon of God, and it is said about each one of us that we are also the image of God. So what is the difference? What makes the Lord Jesus Christ unique than us in this aspect? The uniqueness is that Christ is the exact representation of God. But what is happening with us, that we sometimes act as representation or as expression of God, and sometimes act as a representation or a expression of ourselves. So what you see in me, Sometimes you see in me God, the smile of God, and sometimes you see in me the wrath of the person. And what God wants us to learn today, to know that in all your daily life, God wants to do something in you, not you wants to do something for him. He wants to do something through you. He wants to beautify Jersey City with such amazing building beside St. Mark's Church. And he is working through us. He's working through the loving people to beautify that city. God wants to improve any area. He wants through his people to improve this area. God wants to build a bridge. And he used some people, and he worked some people to build that bridge. God wants to raise more people for him, and he used his people, and through them he raised these people. God created only two persons, and he wanted to create more. So he used me and you, that he created us, and through us, our children. It is not us, it is him. It is not us who is working, it is him who is working in us. Theologically, there is a movement that called pantheism. Pan means all. Theism means divinity. So they proclaim, or their agenda to proclaim, that all is divine. And the church rejected this idea. But there is another view that says panentheism. Panentheism. Panentheism means ban all in theism in divinity. All is in divinity. And this is to somehow is correct, because all the world, all the creation, all the people, all what we see or what we don't see is in God. God is not an individual person who is in a place and all the creation another place. The monotheism of God is not making God an individual apart from the creation, but the monotheism which we believe in is God is all, and all is in God. And there is another view that says theism in ban. So pantheism, panentheism, and theism in ban. And this is to some extent is right. Theism in ban, that means that God is in all. God is in all. And this is what St. Paul said, that he is in all and by all. So I want you to have the sense today that God is in all. That is to say, God is in you. God is in me. Do you not know that you are the temples of God and the Spirit of God dwells in you? You are the temples of God. In you, God is moving. In you, God is working. In you, God is doing his mission. In you, God is working by his will. Let him does his will in you, that you can be a family with the Lord Jesus Christ, a mother, a sister, and a brother, if you do the will of God. Glory be to God forever and ever. Amen.